Good evening, good evening, good evening. And welcome to my stream of Crusader Kings 2. This is Count John D. This is a playthrough that we've been having here for, wow, almost 140 years already. Time sure does fly. But now, oops. Just a little mix up there. But anyway, my plan here right now is the invasion of Scotland. They have it coming. They've been hassling me for quite a while, and now it's time for Scotland to be part of Scandinavia, whether they want to or not. Alright, so now, I've already started the war and declared it on, I believe he's my half-brother? Oh, sorry, no, he's my nephew. His father was my half-brother. Of Scotland. He is 8 years old, and we're going to take away his fancy crown. Okay, so now, given that he has a lot of forces, we are going to try at least to call. Actually, do I have a useless artifact? I can't. Don't have enough money to give him the money, but yeah, I'll try to call him to arms. Yeah, I'll call both him and England. Going to, I think we're actually just going to raise everything and then see what we can pull in an amount of time that is reasonable. Yeah, that's actually shooting something I probably shouldn't be. Let's go a little closer here. Yeah, that's about 1,256 guys. We're just going to cut those out. This may seem to be a very inefficient way of doing this, but we're getting raided. We don't care. These guys can just immediately jump to their ships. We're gonna converge, I believe, here. They have a lot of ships. Meantime, those guys are just gonna march over there. The upland guys can just. Okay, just getting a little notifications about the order, the society I'm in, because I'm currently a member of the Benedictine Order, I believe. Yes, the Benedictine Order. I'm currently in the process of building a nice little church for them to show them I'm a really nice Christian guy. Oh, it looks like it's going to be built any day now. Just after this autosave finishes doing its thing. And then we're going to check to see whether we have enough. Let's see, we've built a church. Okay. Okay, good. English, the English are joining us in the war against the Scots. As we obviously know, it's very easy to convince the English that the Scottish need a good beating. Let me see. Blessed Oblatus Edwick, we are pleased to have completed the church. New temple now, which should go a long way to seek the signal of God even further. Okay, that's good. I gained 300 devotion, which is not quite the 1,000 I need for a promotion in the order, but you know, it's still good. Oh, holy okay, now this. Oh yeah, shit! I forgot. I still have some territory in Scotland, and this is probably going to get attacked if I don't do this. Just you guys. Here should just be walking up. Nitaros, just gonna go here. This is gonna cost us a shit ton of money. We're gonna go in a little bit of a negative trying to finish up this war, but that should be fine enough. Yeah, now we're gonna make sure to put these guys over there, not to give them a little bit of free war score over nothing. Oh shit, I probably forgot about the Russians. Okay, the Russians were just raised somewhere else, or they are maybe unraisable because currently they've been losing too many men in their revolts. That could be. Wait, is that not part of Puerto Rico? You know, yeah, of course. This is actually in my Demesne, because Demesne, or tree, Demesne, I gotta remember. It's actually called Demesne. Yeah, just remember this. See this word over here there? That is pronounced Demesne. Do not ask me why. Actually, do ask me why. I actually relatively know how. It's because it's apparently a French word, and French words are weird. I think everything is going all right though. These guys go over there to those boats. Those guys go to those boats. Those guys go okay. Those boats. We're technically in a war, but I believe we're actually fine off without it. I think we actually really could use the diplomacy. Hey, that's actually pretty good. Okay, how many troops do you actually have to be gathered here? This guy doesn't want to be my friend. That's a little bit mean of him. But it is nice to be part of the Benedictine Order here. Actually, can we give spiritual advice to... Yeah. Okay. Yeah, she doesn't actually have any sins that we don't have. Actually, she does. We do not threaten this way. Can we give spiritual guidance, I'm wondering? It's not a commander. Okay, that makes sense. You can't do this while you're commanding an army, apparently. How silly. Apparently you can't give someone spiritual advice while you're being in an army and while you're invading other countries. That's interesting. Okay. For the love of God, I should probably split up the... they're carrying armies, so it's actually can't split, but we're gonna... make sure that they don't stay raised like this for too long, because they are costing us a fair amount of cash. But I thought I told you guys to get over here. The Duchess of Lorraine has taken Cammy. Well, yeah, I don't give a shit about that. That's fine. Okay, when we've gathered all of our troops, we're then gonna go sail over to Scotland. We're just gonna ignore the rudimentary defeats we're gonna be suffering for a little while. As you people are leaving my defensive pact, I bet they're going to be joining up straight back in when this war is over. Wait. What just happened? Why did I gain a bunch of threat? I was no longer threatening, and then I became threatening again. Can I not see why I'm threatening? Okay, it's here, I believe? It's, yeah. Scandinavian claim on Kiev. Civil War Rus. Scandinavian Holy War for Finland. 7.21. I think I took this a while back. Why does it say ruler of Rus? That is actually, I'm not exactly sure what that means. But the Scandinavian claim on Kiev and the Scandinavian Holy War Finland do make sense. Hell of a lot of people joining my defensive pact. Well, the defensive pact against me, which is actually not very nice of them, I gotta say. Okay, so... yeah, okay. We've gotten our 11,000 men, so we should be plenty enough with the help of our friends here to go over into Scotland. I mean, England is supplying 12,000 troops to us. Yeah, this war is a slam dunk. And the Holy Roman Empire isn't even there yet. Yeah, this is a bit of a crush right here. Let me see. dangerous factions, though. This is something that you'd probably try to take care of. Gavelkind succession in Scandinavia. That's something we don't want to see. He wants queen. She wants a lot of things to fall under her control. Although she is the queen of, actually the queen of Sweden, but is she also the queen of, yeah, she's also the queen of Norway, but she does have very limited territory within it. Like if you look, actually looking in Norway. Actually, she has both. And yeah, both are under Gavelkind succession, though, I believe. Yeah, Cognatic Gavelkind. So, in a generation or so, she is going to have to lose that claim, but negative 100. Oof, jeez, we've got to be able to. What's the County of Hålogaland? Okay, we're going to have to use Steam. Don't need that. Anyway, I think we're going to have to go over to the fine title of the region plan. Because I actually don't remember how Hålogaland is. I remember it's somewhere here. Oh yeah, it's that county and it's in Nidaros and it's vassals right under me. Okay, that definitely seems like it's going to be worth putting under her, just specifically because it's going to ease her up by 25. It wants control of the Duchy of Uppland, the Duchy of Östergötland. The Duchy of Uppland is currently just in this duke, which I don't really want to give her, to be honest. But I'm perfectly fine giving her Östergötland. Like, she's off my dynasty, but this is still looking pretty freaky. Or not to say freaky, but annoying. She's currently betrothed to my kinsman, heir to the High Chiefdom of Finland. Yeah, she's my daughter, and she's going for Gavelkind. Okay, of course, because she would inherit some of the stuff based on Gavelkind, which is why that is. Yo. Well, anyway, sorry for that interruption. What we're going to do here is, again, sorry, actually, I kind of lost my train of thought. Oh yeah. I was thinking about the faction that we have aimed against putting Gavelkind succession in Scandinavia, and there are actually a few ways to deal with factions when you have them because they can be really powerful and really annoying. Sometimes you can try to hide the rebellious faction under bigger vassals. Which I actually think I'm gonna do, because in this case, if we give her, can I not give her Östergötland? Did we already do that? Oh yeah, we haven't gone through forward in time because we should. Shouldn't it be? Yeah, it should be illegal for him to be in this faction because he's not a direct vassal. Yeah, okay, it fixed itself. Okay, so now he's not a direct vassal of the faction, but all of his force power is still being added to the revolt because she's still in on it. But I think if we award honorary title, then we're gonna arrange control. Or can we not form a defensive pact? Not defensive pact, like, can we not get a non-aggression pact anywhere here? Why is the option blacked out, I wonder? Because I know we don't have one, and she's my daughter, so I should be able to get one. Okay, let's try to find someone around here. See if there's, like, yeah, they didn't do any changes to that, I don't think. stats, but she's of my dynasty, so it should be mostly fine. Okay, we can probably appease the King of Rus with a marriage, though. He's married to a kinswoman. I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna break. Wait. Okay, it's a kinswoman under someone else's control. She has an unbetrothed daughter, though. So, let me see, he's 14 years old, so... Yeah, Sweethelm, courtier in Scandinavia, who is my nephew. That should put a force us into a non-aggression pact, and by so doing, making sure that faction doesn't cause too much ruckus in the future. 16 stewardship? Does he have too much? And it's like a malcontent? I don't actually particularly like that. I'm gonna see if we can try to find to invite someone that has better stewardship than that. So what I'm gonna do is just go join at the joint court, search all, and then see what I can find based on that. Okay. Yeah, maybe I should actually be looking at that a little bit at this whole war that I'm doing. But anyway, I think what I'm actually gonna do is go to Viewcan. Okay, that's fine. Nomad agitation, Tritisan, Corbier. Anyway, sorry for that interruption, Tristan. Okay, we basically have nomad agitation over here, and that is actually really annoying to deal with for many reasons, including the fact that they'll basically just form their own nomadic regions, or probably join with this one. Are they next to each other? I believe they are. Okay, so they're basically just going to join that horse lord, I believe, after... Is it... I don't know if it's when we die... Like, even if it's just like a single county, the 450 gold, and that's not even in our domain, it can be worth it just to spend the 450 gold, just make them a just build a castle, and it'll often be just fine. The thing is, you can, do the whole earth fort of building that entire thing up. But when it's under a vassal, I tend to not to like trying to do that to convert, to deal with the nomad agitation, because your NPC vassals will just tend to never turn it into a castle for some reason, and I think it's just kind of a worst of time and effort. Okay, that's actually quite good. You are going to be my steward, and. Do we want just more money? We're in a slight low negative. I think what we actually want to do is just build our capital, which is in Holstein over here, and try to get more tech into it. Castle infrastructure, light infantry. And let's get noble customs. Like, there is some argument to just immediately going and putting our capital in Kunigarth. Because it has six counties, but I don't particularly like doing that while we have the new administration penalties. So I'm not going to make that the capital until we've had that for a little while. Oh yeah, I still have some tribals, but that's fine. We're trying to convert these tribal lands. This one. This one is getting built. Is building a castle, so that one's just going to be built. That one's just going to change by itself. Finland... I could make this county into a minor theocracy, and that would be fine, because it already has a temple. But I'm gonna try to convert it. Like, if I can just convert the religion, build one more castle, it should be fine. This thing already has the best fort, and what could just get upgraded? Arsenal 1? Arsenal 2? Yeah, that's worth 600 prestige. Dangerous factions, increased council power in Scandinavia. That I also do not like that. It's really annoying that my daughter is the one to cause me all of this hassle. Duchy of Smaland. Greenfield. And Prince Wolf. That should at least buy that one off. He's the Count of Nordland, and Nordland here is in Finnmark. We are the Duke of Finnmark, I believe. Although, I want to make sure that I don't have too many duchies, though. Do I have a too many duchies penalty? I do not. He wants to be the Duke of Finland, but... like, we're gonna let him do that. Okay. I don't think we need to rush this war, so I'm actually feeling quite content with just seeing it slowly. Okay, that's probably fine. We're gonna get rid of the scurvy just fine. Okay, he likes us a lot more, because when we have peacetime, I'm going to try to actually make sure that we have a Catholic ruler of Rus. Because it feels like rebellions and successions are going to be a lot likelier to happen as long as all of these territories are Orthodox, while still being under us. So it feels like it probably is going to be better to put some effort towards converting that. And that's actually one of the reasons why I kind of want to try to go before the head of the Benedictine Order. Because getting the ability to just automatically convert... after eating plenty of different food and fruits and vegetable life and finally, well, the pain is gone and I'm in much better state. I'm sure to avoid scurvy if I eat an orange. Door hinge? It feels like this is a reference to something, I just don't know what is. Okay, the faction came and then went. Okay, their betrothal fell, but... can I somehow get a betrothal or a marriage, maybe, that actually gets me a non-aggression pact with my daughter somehow? No. Okay, she doesn't have any siblings, and if she dies, I just get all of this her stuff, so I'm just gonna let this happen. I'm just gonna, you know, not interfere with that at all. We can call in the King of Hungary, but I don't particularly like doing that, especially because Hungary, if we ever war with Poland again, or Wallachia, they're gonna be a lot more useful than here. Especially when it looks like we're definitely winning this war, just no matter what. We outnumber them more than 3-1, and it just looks like their whole thing is just going to be a mess. Okay, our defensive pact is gone, but a new defensive pact will definitely exist. We have some over here. It is definitely going to come into place when... okay, I think I'm confidently saying we won't need to sail anything away, so I think... the actual ships here, we're just gonna disband them. Because, like, even if we somehow miraculously lose this war, which I sincerely doubt's gonna happen, we can just disband our troops in Morai here that we already have. Sigaretic. Yeah, sure. It's a fine-ish guy. Yeah, that actually, I believe, the marriage that provides us the Holy Roman Empire. No, it provides us an ally with... okay, maybe that was not a marriage I should have approved, but whatever. Her father was a Byzantine emperor, though, so it's a decent enough prestige into the dynasty, so it's not that bad. It's a nice little prestige into that marriage. Save us some cash. Well, I can kill both of my king-sized vessels, but why? Acted dishonorable. I don't want to ruffle the boat. I don't want to ruffle feathers that I just simply don't need to ruffle. Ugh, it's way too bright in here. Okay, but anyway, this is just looking like it's... we lost like about half our war score because they sieged this. But honestly, it's gonna be fine. The moment we finish sieging that, we're just gonna take that army down and then get... and then basically assault our way back down to get all of those, and it's just going to be fine. Although, we should probably put commanders in place just in case. Okay, these commanders suck. I'm just gonna try to invite all of the good generals in existence that can actually provide us with decent commanders. Certainly went back to court. Today, your hunting dog suddenly flew into rage, tore loose, and attacked one of your courtiers. Heal! Some reason. It's weird. It's probably like it's something really weird, random changed, and then his opinion was slightly lower or something like that. Okay, and I'm gonna name you Commander of the Realm, and I'm gonna name you Commander of the Realm, and I'm gonna name you Commander of the Realm. We lost some troops to some troops to diseases. We're having a weird situation where there's a Welsh duchy that's actually doing all that, and England has doing really well in conquering Wales. Let's see what else here we have going on. Prestige or Paddy's going well. We haven't gotten a maiden mission yet. We have about 825. It's declared Sochaska at Finchables 4 for Finland on High Chief of Finland. The only thing I find weird about the whole devotion system is that if the same resource that's used to like level up your rank in the society is the same that lets you do things with the society, it leads to a weird thing where you get the highest ranked for doing the least amount of things, but I suppose it makes some sense somehow. Actually, I kind of want to see the expected successor has 457 power. How much do I have? This is the member score. Where are we? Yeah, there we are. We are 255 with our rank. Because what's computer is. Yeah. Oblata space 10. And that had been the different things give percentage bonuses. So yeah, I could see us maybe getting to the highest order in the highest place in the Benedictine order. And when we're its head, we can then just use our leveraged Adna order to start converting a bunch of counties. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of this whole situation, because now we have got a relatively devoted guy in charge of a fairly large swath of territory. He's got a lot of kids though, so this is gonna split up. And because he's tribal, he's stuck on Gavelkind. He's gonna get split up hard. And when he does, we can probably kick. We can probably just take some of the pieces and be happy with that. It is still kind of annoying that we don't have the entirety of the empire's du jour. Because if we look at the du jour empire, we're not spreading to Rus because Russia, the Russian kingdom is huge. Oh, sorry, this empire, the kingdom. Yeah, we're not spreading to Rus because we don't have the 80% of it that I think that needs to be tried to convert. Yeah, but this duchy in there is getting the spread. So Mr. Metalpod 6 has ended. Okay. I'm guessing the guy that was attacking these guys, yep. Truce with High Chief Sigrid. Okay, that's actually quite fine. He fended off the other tribal. Now he's got basically nothing. Well, free county for us, I guess, then. After we, of course, kick the Scots down. Let's help our Orgrim allies here defeat the Scots. we should be able to get there before that battle is over, hopefully, and if not, I think our army is still gonna win. And their morale is gonna be, you know, slightly down. And if we get to there before the battle ends, like I think we are, we get to keep the defensive territory in the hills. And that essentially means that we are greatly advantaged in this fight, not even counting the numbers. So that is actually pretty good. Not even counting the numbers, we're gonna have to do. Like, we could win this fight with equal or slightly below their numbers, but with the numerical advantage that we have, we're just gonna crush this. Yeah, like I thought. And I think that we're then gonna just start assaulting. Yeah, we're gonna assaulting places like that. Yeah, definitely gonna assault that. Then make a northern swing around there. Let me see. Church has 2,200. Yeah, it's not worth it. We're just gonna try to retake Mirai. Ugh, that's actually pretty scary. The Muslims are shooting out the Byzantines. Mike has agreed to buy him some books of autonomy. 44 girls in the answer. Like, sometimes your doctor will get approved by this, and that's fine. Sometimes you'll get a tiny little bit of prestige, which is fine. Like, I usually think the most of the events you can get out of that are worth it, except, like, the really horrible ones. The really horrible ones, even the worst-case scenario, is, like, you get a bit of a worse doctor, and then you just fire your doctor and get a new one, so it's honestly not even that bad. Okay, we're just gonna assault that. And we're gonna assault that. We now have a score of 100%. And we're gonna pause just to make sure nothing crazy happens in about 1 or 2 days. Because, like, if we manage to complete the claims, and then our claimant, which is the Philotethos, the usurper of Scotland, even if that happens, it won't actually... he's despot because he's Greek. It won't even be that bad. I forgot what I was going to say. Yeah, sorry, it won't even be that bad because basically the guy we put in, we get the entire empire, and then just whoever his heir is, which is this random guy, gets to be there instead. So that's honestly just fine. So now, I believe, is our cousin, who is now the King of Scotland, and that just seems fine. We can probably keep them under heel for the rest of the game, probably, which is quite nice. And now, we have a shit ton of threat. So if we're gonna declare a war on someone small, we're probably gonna do it, hopefully, before they get a chance to join the defensive pact. And that actually very well might be Corellia over here. Okay, just gonna make sure we don't have any raised troops. Probably forgot some. No, okay, we didn't forget some. The Russians are getting raided by these guys, but I don't care. Cannot find myself to care. Can I demand? Nope. Wait, what if I gift you? Okay. That's probably gonna help a fair deal. A free county there seems pretty good. Although, are there any weak claims against the Byzantines? Nah, I don't feel like doing that. I'm Holy Roman Empire? Nope. I don't think I particularly want to put these claims forward. They're actually not even going to give me anything. Yeah, just getting Corellia out of the way, just getting another county out of the way seems pretty fine, actually. Oh, okay, we have a truce with that guy. Okay, that makes actually sense. Never mind. Although, maybe we should try to war this guy. He's actually true. Like, almost all the territory is still Swamanesco, but he's a Sunni tribal. That's Swamanesco. There's one guy over there. And the only dangerous guy here is this guy. But actually, how powerful are they right now? 600 troops, 100 piety. Yeah, they're actually ripe for the taking right now. And we can probably take... Ugh. Why does this have to be split up like this? One county over there. One county over there. Actually, we could probably declare all three wars and win if none of them are particularly pious. This one's got like 400. This one's got like 160. Yeah, we could definitely take Rami and... and the rest of Garmia easy. Or maybe we should declare a war on Ugra just because we can get three counties and three counties. Two, three. Yeah, actually, just taking Ugra. Actual Ugra actually might be better, especially if they... Okay, they have both the titles. And either way, we're going to miss one of the counties because of this revolt. Actually, not if the revolt resolves itself by then, so that should probably be fine. I think we're going to declare a holy war on Ugra and on Rummy over here. We're also going to declare a holy war for Yarmia, chiefdom of Mari. No, not a random chief that has one county that got raided. Don't call him over to my war. That might be very scary. Okay, we're also going to declare that war. And then we're going to see what armies we can raise in a short amount of time. Here is... Okay, we're not going to do that, but Mirai is decent, I believe. 237. Rusk is about 700. We're going to need a few thousand, I believe. But, okay, the Russian Revolt. Ooh, actually, they're not... Yeah, that's probably going to be shorter, so we're down. Yeah. Oh, this revolt is pretty powerful, actually. I think we're going to finish that war off first before we head anywhere else. Shineland has 2,000 troops, yeah. The Shineland here is just going to meet up there. These guys are just going to meet up there. Then we have Ipland, which can sail 600 troops in there. That's probably going to be a good idea. We're going to sail here, then sail to Ingria, and that should probably do it. Ooh, Lithuanians are revolting. That's actually quite good. We do want them to split up if possible. Actually, we haven't really let any days pass. I feel being a bit conservative and not really bothering with Lithuania for now, letting that revolt resolve and letting them split up. It just seems like the safe option right now. It's probably not the smartest option necessarily, but it is definitely the safest option. So I do kind of like that because my succession still isn't the most stable in the world. It's elective, and they're voting a mediocre character, which is not too bad. Like, I'm really hoping that my currently youngest son gets voted in, or that I can change the inheritance law that out of his range. I need to have the only things I need to have. I believe does ultimate gender require imperial? Let me see. As the law, full council must not be true. Okay, wait. Okay, it's no vassals fighting each other. Yeah, that's not gonna be happening. Is that no regency? One of these must be true. The late feudal administration has the imperial. Empire Company, one of these must be true. Has the limited, medium, high. Oh, yeah, this is like if you're not conclave. Then the crown authority is the thing that matters, but all of the holding must not be true. Has the law full council authority, and has the law elective monarchy. Must not be true. Has the law elective monarchy. Yeah, you can't ultimate into prim, but elective monarchy into that, but can you go for primogeniture? You need to have imperial administration either way. You can't have Imperial Administrations until you have a Majesty of at least 5. I only have a Majesty of 3, and it's gonna and tech in this game takes time to develop, so that doesn't feel like it's gonna happen soon. Centralization. Yeah, we have to have a tolerance of 4 before we can move that law up. I'm just checking, or is there anything else that we really care about? Okay, we can't really do any law changes that we want to do. Like, we could change church taxes and make chat tax the church more. Yeah, let's just do that. That seems fine. We don't need that many church. I don't really care for the church. I just want to have the greater amount of money. Yeah, I need to be a piss. I don't care if he is at war. Let me see, what is this war for Russ? I just bothered changing him, so I'm gonna see if I can ask for peace with him. Because I don't particularly want this revolt to succeed. Yeah, we're gonna then sail these upland troops up to Austria, because they can turn up. We already raised Shyland over there? Did we? No, we didn't. The Shyland troops are just gonna walk. They're just gonna walk there from here. Then is a question of, do we want the Swedish troops? And if so, we're probably gonna just raise them. Yeah, I think we're just gonna raise them over there, because they can actually just start attacking them from right there. Okay. Excellent. The war into the fallen peace terms. It's particularly war on the general. Now this guy's got to be liking me a fair bit, yeah. He does, the only thing he doesn't like about me is that I don't have him on the council, but with actually an intrigue of 23, yeah, you can, and the fact that he already really likes me, I'm gonna make him my spy master. It's unlike my daughter, the Queen of Sweden, that unfortunately has terrible stats in basically everything. So she's, okay, to be fair, this character has pretty good stats now, but... Actually, never mind. This is not the character that I'm remembering. I'm remembering his father, Wolf, I believe. This character's got pretty decent stats, actually. All of these are actually pretty good. Ugh, these horse lords are getting really... Okay, these horse lords are getting really united, and that sect actually does not bode well for you, for us. Okay, like, this usually always happens, but it's one mon- it's the thing I don't like about him is that it's, okay, whatever. The thing I don't particularly like about this is that this is all from coming from a Muslim source, and that makes it a lot worse, because that means that they not only can deal holy war, but when they do, they will actually, Is that a Germanic flag? Why is there a Germanic flag there? Okay, but it's this Womanesco guy, Pagan, who's going to get some back to him. We're not at war with these guys, these are just raiding us, I believe? Or is Slinov? Or is Slinov actually? Yeah, actually, no, man, these are actually those guys. We do really want to make sure that we curb the Muslim influence here in the north. We really do not want to see big, powerful Muslims anywhere around here. Actually, what troops can these guys raise? I know it's not a lot because they're almost entirely tribal. Yeah. Next time we can make law, I'm probably going to raise tribal taxes because, yeah, they're just. Shit. Because they just overall. Don't particularly matter that much. Yeah, we're just gonna gather there and then head into Romney. after we capture that, we're gonna have a 100 war score immediately, so that'll at least be nice. They seem to have 13, and that's the revolts, or is that those guys? Actually, that is those guys. You're gonna need... Yeah, the Swedish troops are probably gonna come and get on the other side of this. They're over there, so I believe that if they try to go over there, we can basically start going over here down, and gather up our full forces that way. Yeah, these tribal holdings have shit for Atna fort level, so it should not be too hard to occupy much of this territory. Or did we wear them for Ugra? Yeah, we wore them for Ugra, so we're basically going to get these. Oh, the revolt ended. That means we actually get their full territories over there, which is actually pretty good. Victory over there. Oh yeah, that is actually in their territory, and it's... Yeah, it's relatively unarmed, so we're just gonna do that. Get built a little bit of war score. And then these troops can march straight into Romney, capture that quickly, end that war before... Like, before some random event makes it harder than it is now. We just put that straight into our Demesne. Put that straight up into our domain. And we're really starting to hope that the border authority starts to convert some of these counties. Ugh. Let's see. Build a new holding. We can probably just... They have on a whole thousand. That's a bit more. Yeah, I think we still just do this. Excellent. Majority of population in Onega. Okay, that actually means that we can... Gonna wait a little bit to upgrade that to a castle. We don't need to do that with this one. Yeah, we're just gonna make a new vassal here in Oscar, and he's gonna be a tribal leader in the castle lands, so that's gonna be fine. He's not gonna like us, he's eventually gonna convert it. It's fine. We're gonna wait a little to upgrade that to a castle, but in the meantime, let's see what else we got. The Finland county is also not of the right position. And after we build that, it becomes a legal target to do that, and then we can do that. Let's see how our religious converting has been going. Except for the weird case where a random county here is a heresy from the Byzantines, is an Orthodox heresy. That's not much. My cousin here. I'm gonna send her a gift and then offer another Christian pack, because this is one lady that has been a little bit of a thorn in my side for a lot of playthroughs. She's been... in power for a very long time. Okay, we 100% the Romney War, so we're just gonna force the demands. Alright, we have the troops over there, and then we're gonna march there. These are Kishkunag? Is the Kishkunag bothering to attack us? Yeah, they're attacking us. Here they're not here to send us. We're looking for new vassals. Let me see. County of Romney. It's a tribal land anyway. I actually could use... This is actually a territory I'm perfectly okay doing this to. That's actually quite nice. They're asking me for a county I would probably be giving away anyway. I might have given it to someone else, but now that she asked for it, yeah, he could be the chief. And that does make it semi-likelier that it'll convert when it's under a single Christian ruler. Oh, wait. Pause. Okay, we've got 1,800, so that makes us close to 5,000. I have from Helmer Bending to your brother, will you, as the Christian scholar you are, please offer me some advice on my poetry or the attempt of reading through the attached documents. There are multiple versions, all in honor of God. I am missing the more comforting aspects of faith. While I enjoy the metaphors, they seem a little forced. Writing is frivolous. I'll just say... I'm missing the more comforting aspects of the faith. Or of faith. This actually leaves me 5,300. I'm going to be slightly... Are they marching for me? No, they're not marching for me. Would I get there before them? 3rd of January? I would. Let's see if we can intercept them. And maybe get a little reinforcements on the way. 8 guys. 22 troops. Let's think this over for a second. Yeah, that's still part of Rus. That's Finland, which is not really a big deal. Here we have the Swedish troops in there, so it's just like Sweden troops, which is 1,000, which we can probably not get them there quick enough. I think we're actually going to win that battle, but I think what we're going to do is ships. Skip the Kiev troops. Yeah, those are nearly 40 ships, so we can probably just... Okay, we got another mission from the Benedictine Order. It is attention that you are perhaps not spending the appropriate amount of matters of theology. We'd like to encourage you to set worldly awareness and focus on matters of divine nature. Okay, sure. I don't particularly need the rest of the bonus here, so sure, theology. Theology also has +1 health now? I don't know if that was always the case, but that makes me more inclined to take it. The Bible shall be my most foremost companion. And now that we're commissus, we just have to live along. Let me see. I was beginning to think Bishop took offense to my comments, but today I received a new draft of his work. I'm surprised to find this world's words really speak to me. Scribbled in the margin, I can just make out, I implore you, brother, bear with me. It is not finished. Nonsense. This is brilliant. And it needs to get published. Okay. Patron of the Arts, get +1 diplomacy. Yeah, I think we're going to do this. The 55 gold for +1 diplomacy is actually going to be pretty good. The Patron of the Arts modifier. So just people are generally going to like me a tiny little bit more with the diplomacy of 20, so that's actually not bad. That we just conquered Scotland, but we're now worried about these rabble. Is that we are going to get the Knights Templar. We're gonna sail here. And we're gonna get the Knights Templar to attack the Muslims. That should pull us up just fine. Thank you. against my wishes, Bishop Jigmar reports to me the poems were far from finished, and now I realize that my metaphors could use work. I have been humiliated, and I put the letter away, frowning. You cannot fault him after seizing an opportunity. He likes me a bit less, but he's still a good friend. 1,500 men. We can run over there. We're still gonna... Yeah, so we can probably turn this war around. This base is one of those sort of, we're just gonna need a bit fewer men than we thought we would, but if we win this war, it's gonna be a heck of a lot easier to just deal with. Usually these 300 men can start marching there. And actually, when the weaponsmith is finished, then we're gonna upgrade it, because then we actually just start with Training Ground 2, which I think is pretty nice. Because with all of the upgrades that it is, it's gonna... With all the upgrades that Onega has, it's going to be a pretty decent castle to start with. Ooh! That's Saint's Finger Broom. Well, I believe that just gives me more piety. Plus, and prestige! Not bad. Waste their time marching while we're doing stuff like this for a little while. Nomads don't have to think about the pagan attrition thing? Or is that just enemies? I don't know. Three, four, five, six. As my troops ransacked the village of Jeremy Drive, they discovered an interesting relic that Chief Yopti had hidden away there. Wonderful news. Throwing axe. That's kind of interesting. See, we currently have battle axe. Throwing axes, quality, martial plus one, martial plus one. Personal combat strength, 120. Okay. I like battle axes better, but we can probably give someone that we want to like us the throwing axe. I'm not seeing for these. We can create a bunch of various kingdom titles. I don't think we're gonna need that, really. Okay, we're gonna march there, besiege, and hopefully we can get to 100 while just wasting their time a bunch. Or maybe we can lure them into a less than favorable attack? That actually might be good. Get into, like, the river crossing, then get reinforcements of about 5,000 men. Hey, Furry Upper 6! How nice to see you there. There. To keep you up to date, we've just been keeping to play Crusader Kings. And as probably the biggest thing that happened while you were gone. Why is it frozen? Is the stream frozen? Is it? I haven't noticed anything. It's looking all good on my end. Like, I basically tend to have a window of the stream open just to make sure that it's working, that I'm seeing the things happening as they are supposed to, and it looks fine on my end, but it still could be something that is causing the transmission to be bad. Let me see. It's looking all right in OBS. It's looking all right on the Twitch page. Are you sure? Wait. Oh, wait, if it's frozen, you probably can't hear me. Okay. Let me see. Let's try to besiege this. Okay. Yeah, I could not care less about someone trying to kill that priest. Let's just assault that down immediately. Okay, it seems that... are these guys bothering with some sort of other... Yadne's host? Okay, are they just raiding me? Is that the only thing? Let me see, Yadne's host is... yeah, defending... against the second Scandinavian Holy War for Ugra, and defending against Yadne of Yadne's host, Claymore and Klinov. Okay. I'll see if this is happening in other streams. Okay, that's fair. Because... it still does look fine on my end. Is there anywhere we can go? It's safe to go? 8,000 guys. It's probably best to split. Pause that for a second. Let's see if we can. We can't split in half. Can't split in board armies, which is annoying because we can't do multi landings basically. This should work out just fine. Cut my swords. Okay, people are leaving defensive packs. For some reason, Doge of Venice wants to marry one of my random courtiers. That doesn't even matter. Does it? Yeah, this looks fine. I'm traveling around here slowly. Let's try to refresh. OBS is doing fine. It's annoying that in this stream we're having all of these technical issues. Maybe if I refresh, I start to see his problems. Yeah. Like, it's the annoying thing about having so few viewers, is that if just... okay, let me see. This guy... betrothed to the King of England... yeah. It's really annoying that we don't have more viewers that could just check this. Let's see where we're going with this. Okay, I think what we're going to do is just see, wait and see to see. I see if I've just gotten risen a viewer. We're kind of checking for technical problems. If you could just leave a comment in chat to see if things are okay. Because we've had a viewer that had complained about some technical issues, which I'm not seeing on my end. Like, I'm not seeing OBS doing anything wrong, and I'm not seeing the actual Twitch page I have open in up another screen do anything weird. So if people could tell me if they spot something weird about this chat, that would be great. Is everyone seeing this frozen? Hmm. default. That's kind of annoying. Bastard Daughter number 76. Sure, be more charitable, why not? Okay, let's see. Who can we root for? Prince of the King and the Prince of what? Prince Alexandros. Oh yeah, his. That's actually a character of my dynasty. Eh, it's fine. Okay, okay. I thought this might have been a battle that we were actually going to lose, but it looks like this battle is doing us just fine. I was just surprised that they were starting the battle overall, but the distraction of the technical problems is sure a real thing. After winning this war, we might actually get enough horse corps to at least win it. Maybe, yeah. No, maybe we'll just need to siege two more territories or so. Very good. The Stonehill Fort is there. Triple is it 3? Oh yeah, you can't do it while you're broke. It's not that we don't have enough prestige. We're gonna wait a little bit until we see that. Gonna have a lead to finish this war. Solve that. Oh yeah, we have 300 troops. Getting more and more artifacts. Let's see what we found this time. We actually found a crown! That's actually pretty useful. The opinion and prestige of that is actually pretty good. It really sucks that we're having fewer problems. We have 100% war score right over here, so we're just going to leave that. Let's try to see if we can take the stream on and off, and let's see if that does something.